After nearly 4 months, the Philippine Supreme Court finally acted on ABS-CBN's temporary restraining order petition against the network's closure. The High Court dismissed the plea, declaring it moot after the media giant's franchise bid was junked by the Philippine House of Representatives. ABS-CBN's Mike Navalio joins us on the line for more details on this story. Mike, good afternoon. What happened?
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. The Philippine Supreme Court unbanked earlier today voted to dismiss the plea of media giant ABS-CBN Corporation to stop the closure order issued by the National Telecommunications Commission in May. Its spokesperson, Brian Kisosaka, confirmed in a unanimous vote, all 14 justices present voted to junk the petition on the ground of being moot since the House of Representatives has denied the corporation's bid to renew its franchise. Associate Justice Priscila Baltazar Padilla is on leave. It was Senior Associate Justice Estela Pelas Bernabe who was the member in charge of the petition. A source, however, told ABS-CBN News that one justice would have voted to grant the status quo ante order and the petition, but ended up concurring in the result following the denial of the franchise and because it was not raised as an issue in the petition. Although ABS-CBN may ask for a reconsideration of the decision, the Supreme Court rarely reverses a unanimous vote, leaving the media giant virtually without any recourse in the High Court. The dismissal comes more than 3 months after ABS-CBN sought refuge from the Supreme Court following the closure order issued by the NTC on May 4, which was implemented on May 5th. ABS-CBN filed a petition for certiorari and prohibition on May 7, alleging grave abuse of discretion on the part of NTC to issue a cease and desist order instead of deferring to Congress and issuing a provisional authority to allow its stations to continue broadcasting. NTC Commissioner Gamaliel Cordoba in March promised to issue a conditional authority or provisional authority, but the Office of the Solicitor General pressured the NTC at the last minute to issue a CDO instead. Cordoba confirmed this to senators in a hearing in late May. It was also the OSG who filed a co-warranto petition against ABS-CBN Corporation and ABS-CBN Convergence in February, seeking to revoke its franchise over alleged violations. But the Supreme Court junked the petition in June for being moot and academic since ABS-CBN's franchise lapsed on May 4th and had already been shut down. The House of Representatives, in a 70-11 vote in July, killed the franchise renewal bid of the corporation after several hearings on supposed legal violations, despite several government agencies clearing the network. The corporation has begun retrenching employees, shutting down lines of business, and downsizing operations. Stanley?
All right. Thanks a lot for the update. Mike Navalio there.